In today's video, I'm going to help you cut down your mowing time, but we're going to do it without buying a ride-on lawnmower. Now, many yards either can't fit a rider, and some people just don't want one. But unfortunately, when you get a walk-behind mower, they only come in one size, and that's 21 inches. But there's one mower that's different. It has a 30-inch deck. It's made by Toro, and it's called the Timemaster. But one thing about this mower bothered me. The majority of the online reviews absolutely love it, but there's a lot of comments about some significant problems. And in this video, I wanted to find out if this mower is worth your money, and most importantly, could it live up to its name. Toro gave me this mower for the review, but they have no control over the content or anything about what I'm going to show you. If you order this mower online and they ship it to you, this is the box it's going to come in. But the good news is, once you open it, it's easy to set up. You just have to unscrew a couple of knobs, the handlebar will fold back, and for the most part, the machine is pretty much set up. Now, of course, if you get it from a dealer, they'll probably do all the setup for you. To complete the setup, you've got to add oil and gas to the engine. Now, fortunately, the oil is easy because they included a pre-measured amount of it inside the bag. And I'm even going to use the bag as something to protect the engine just in case I spill any. Now, you can use the pre-measured bottle and just pour it in and you should be done, but you want to double check the level to be sure. The engine on this model is pretty big. It's a 223cc engine made by Briggs & Stratton, but you need that large motor because you're actually driving two blades to do the cutting. I've just got to add gas to get the mower ready to use, but there's an important point here, and that's around the gas tank. This tank is not very big, so when you're filling it up, you can overfill it really quickly, so you want to be aware of this before you start pouring the gas in. Another plus is you've got a fuel filter, and this will really protect your carburetor and ultimately your engine. Starting the mower for the first time was pretty easy. It only took a couple of pulls to get the machine running. Now remember, the blades aren't spinning when this thing first starts up, so that's really nice if you've got to stop to pick something up, or you just want to let the machine warm up. Now when you want to stop the machine, all you need to do is push the stop button, but you do need to hold it in. The machine is self-propelled with this thing they call personal pace. Now you just hold onto the handlebars and you walk. If you walk faster, the machine will go quicker. If you walk slower, the machine will go slower. It's really as easy as that. The biggest complaints I read online was about this machine stalling out when you try to engage the blades. Now here I flipped that blue tab up, squeezed the handle, and the blades engaged okay, but they sounded a little bit weird to me. So I tried it again and I went a lot faster, and as you can see, the machine completely stalls out. Now this actually happened to me while I was using the machine, but I never read the manual. And what they tell you is you need to engage that handle slowly. And when I did it this way, it worked perfectly every time. Now on my Walker commercial mower, this is exactly how you're supposed to do it. This is the control handle to engage the blades. You're not supposed to just yank it up because you can actually damage the clutch in the machine. You're taught to do it slowly and smoothly to get a good smooth engagement. Now we're onto some real lawn mowing, and here I'm using the bagger. Now when you use a bag, you should expect the best cut you can get because everything's going in the bag and you're not leaving anything behind. But the first thing I noticed was how little time it was taking me to cut this space. Now I normally use my Honda 21-inch mower in this area, and that's an awesome mower, but it takes a certain amount of time to get the job done. And here I felt like I was kinda done in no time. So in terms of time, this thing really did a great job, but what about the quality of the cut itself? As I looked here closely, this thing did really great. I didn't see any grass sticking up. Even the wheel tracks really weren't sticking up at all after the cut. The other big plus is the size of the bag. This thing is huge and it seemed to do a great job filling it up. But one other huge benefit was the mess that it didn't create. Now I love my Honda mower, but one thing that drives me crazy is it gets a lot of grass in the hinge that I have to kind of brush out by hand. What was really unusual about this Toro is there was like nothing on the back of the machine. So it was kind of a nice surprise, and overall that just allows me to spend less time cleaning the machine and hopefully just more using it. Now onto the real test, let's see how well this thing can mulch grass with no bag at all. I wanted to start by lowering the height of cut to about 2¾ inches. Now on this machine it's great. They only have two levers, one for the front and one for the back. Now these levers are huge. This is a lot better than many other designs that you can hardly even get your hands on. Now they're lettered between A and G. Now I would have preferred if it gave you the inches, but in the book they do tell you exactly what height of cut you'll get with each setting. Getting the mower into mulching mode is pretty easy, but it does require two steps. Now the first one is simple, just take the bag off the mower and set it aside. Now you need to use this. This is called a mulching plug, and essentially what it's doing is blocking the grass from coming out of the mower so that it can grind it up and mulch it back into the lawn. Now using this plug is pretty easy, but you do have to put it in the right direction. And it's got a tab on there, and that needs to face up. For the mulching test, I'm going to be cutting dry grass and wet grass. Started slowly because I wanted to see how the mower would perform. Now this is the dry section of my lawn and there were no issues at all, so I just started to walk at a normal pace. Now we're onto the wet section of my lawn, and there were a number of comments online saying that this machine performed poorly in wet or damp grass, so I wasn't really sure what to expect. But as I went through this area, I didn't have any problems at all. This lawn definitely needed to be cut, and I'm walking at a normal pace and I had no issues at all. The majority of the reviews on this mower were really good, but I like to read the negatives because sometimes there's some truth in there and some good information. In this case, I think the majority was right because my results mulching with this mower were excellent. I had no problems with wet or dry grass, but you've got to remember when you're mulching with any mower, you want to try to have the lawn be dry. I used this mower for hours and the experience was excellent. It had a great quality of cut, but it worked equally well whether I was bagging or mulching. But the real reason you want to buy this machine is to reduce the amount of time that you'll spend mowing, but at least now you'll know that the end result will be as good or even better than the mower you might be using today. So if you like seeing this pretty cool mower and it might save you some time in the future. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you're not already for more videos coming up.